The Amazon Echo is a small and useful device to have around the home, but if you're not sure if you really need one and have a Raspberry Pi laying around, you can make your own. There are a few things that you'll need to get everything up and running. I'd recommend a Raspberry Pi 3. If you have an older Raspberry Pi Model 2, that should work, but the Raspberry Pi Model 1 will not. You'll also need a USB microphone. I used a podcast style microphone, but any USB microphone will work. And you'll also need a speaker with a 3.5mm connection so that you can connect it to your Pi. I used a SenseBot Move Mini. You can check out the review of that in the card above. You can do the setup via a keyboard and mouse, or you can use SSH. It doesn't matter, the commands will be the same. But before we can start setting up anything on the Raspberry Pi, we'll need to create an Amazon Developer account, and this can be done by going to the Amazon Developer Services and following the procedure and prompts for creating an account. Now that you've logged into your Amazon Developer account or signed up, it's time to configure the Alexa service under the Developer account so that you can use Alexa on the Raspberry Pi. Go back to the Amazon Developer Services homepage and select Alexa from the different options displayed. This will take you to the Alexa Developer homepage. Hover over your Alexa consoles, which can be found at the top right of the web page, and select Alexa built-in devices. Then click on products and click the create product button. This is where the credentials for the Raspberry Pi to connect to the Alexa service will be generated. And on this screen, you'll need to enter the product name and product ID. I chose to enter Alexa Pi, but you can choose your own name if you'd prefer. Select device with Alexa built-in as the product type and select other as the product category. Enter Alexa Pi into the category and description text boxes. There are a few more checkboxes and buttons to click below, so let's do those too. Check hands-free for how all users interact with your product, and then for the remaining buttons, select no for all of them. Click next. Now you need to create a security profile for the product that you've just created. Click create new profile and give it a name and description. Again, click next. Now we've completed the initial setup of the product, we need to add some URLs to the Allowed Origins and Allowed Return URLs section at the bottom of the page. For this section, you'll also need the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. To get this, you can type ifconfig into the terminal of your Pi, or you can use the Adafruit Pi Finder, which I will link below. Under Allowed Origins, add http://localhost:5050, and then https://localhost:5050. Then you'll also want to add the same, but replace localhost with the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. So I have entered http://192.168.0.219:5050. And again, change that to HTTPS like the other ones with https://192.168.0.219:5050. Obviously entering your own Pi's IP address into those final two boxes. Then you'll want to do a similar thing for the allowed return URLs, and you'll want to begin off again with localhost. So http://localhost:5050/code. Then https://localhost:5050/code. And like before, those, but replacing localhost with the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. Once you've done that, you can agree to the terms, conditions, and click finish. Now some capabilities need to be added to the product, so click on the product name and click capabilities on the left-hand side. Check the named timers and reminders checkbox, and then display cards, and then display cards with text. Once you've done that, click the update button at the bottom of the page, and it's time to move over to the Raspberry Pi. Before we do continue, I'd recommend that you grab a USB stick and make a text file containing the client ID, client secret, and security profile ID. If you're using SSH, you don't need to worry about copying them to USB, and the client ID and secret can be found on any page under the product you've created, and the security profile ID can be found on the security profile tab. It will be a lot easier to copy and paste these into your Raspbian terminal than manually type them in, as it is a very long code. Now with the preparation out of the way, it's time to install the Alexa service to the Raspberry Pi. To do this, we shall be using a piece of software called Alexa Pi. Although Alexa Pi is no longer under active development, it still manages to work well at the time of this tutorial. The first step will be to make sure your Raspberry Pi is up and running and open up the terminal. First of all, we need to make sure we are in the OPT directory by typing in cd/OPT. Since Alexa Pi is hosted on GitHub, we'll also need to make sure that Git is installed onto the Pi. We can do this by typing in sudo apt-get install git. Now we can clone the AlexaPy repository to the storage on the Raspberry Pi by typing in sudo git clone https://github.com/alexa-pi/alexapy.git. Now that AlexaPy has been downloaded, it's time to run the setup script by typing in sudo /alexapy/src/scripts/setup.sh. Don't worry, I will leave a link in the description to a blog post with all of the commands that you'll need. From here, you've got to follow the prompts that show up in the terminal. Many of them will be filled in by default, but you will be asked whether you want AirPlay functionality and if you want Alexa to automatically run on startup. And at the end, you'll also need to enter your Amazon product credentials that we created earlier. When asked to enter your device type ID, enter the product ID that you created earlier. And once you've done that, you'll need to copy and paste your client ID, client secret, and security profile ID into the terminal. Once you've entered those, you can browse to the URL displayed on the terminal of the Raspberry Pi and log into your Amazon account. Once you've done that, you can press Ctrl C to close the window, and AlexaPy is set up. And the final stage to make sure that Raspbian has the correct configuration so that AlexaPy will work without any issues is to change the boot mode and audio output settings. So first of all, let's open up the Raspberry Pi configuration screen by typing in sudo raspi-config. And now you want to go down to the boot options option and select desktop/CLI and select the console as the boot option. AlexaPy has some issues when booting up into desktop mode, so changing the boot mode to console will resolve these. The next step will be changing the audio output, so go down to the Advanced Options tab and select Audio. Here you can override the automatic settings and force the Raspberry Pi to use the 3.5mm output by selecting Force 3.5mm bracket headphone jack. Now that you've done that, you can go across to Finish at the bottom and Reboot. When your Raspberry Pi boots back up, you should hear Alexa say hello. And that means that you're all ready to go and you can begin asking Alexa some questions. Just make sure that you've got that microphone plugged in. But that's been it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.